Halo, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, hello, good day to all friends from all the rest of the world. Welcome to this very humble internationally broadcast of the book launch with the title The Intraocular Lens Power Calculation. The event also a tribute to 77-year celebration of Indonesian Independence Day. This webinar attended by hundreds of participants from 64 countries of 6 continents around the world. Salam Merdeka, let's start the event. To honor the origin country of this very event, please pay attention to Indonesia National Anthem. Thank you so much. First and foremost, please allow me to cherish and express my appreciation to my best friends, fellow contributors, and publisher for their hard work and commitment to make this book project into reality. With us right now, Professor Steve Arshinoff from University of Toronto, Canada, and Professor Naveen Rao from Tufts University, Boston, Massachusetts, United States of America. This is our humble contribution to the effort for helping the people against blindness. The story of the book, from humble beginning, at the very first time, Dr. Ashwin Agarwal from India and Dr. Sergio Canabrava from Brazil ordered me to be a panelist on one session of intraocular lens power calculation in the meeting of World Webinar of Cataract and Refractive Surgery in 2021. 1 year ago, just 1 year ago. And I met in there with Professor Naveen Rao from United States of America and Professor Giacomo Savini from Italy. In there as speaker and moderator. And so later, I discussed with them, and also my close friend, Professor Steve Arshinoff from Canada, Professor Oliver Findl from Austria, and surely Professor Marie-Josée Tassignon from Belgium to arrange a book project. So voila, here we go. Some friends asked me, including Dr. Richard Packer from United Kingdom, what your aim on objective or purpose of this book? I tried to answer the fundamental question. I think that I determined to unify more information about IOL power calculation. Those have been scattered on so many journals into hopefully one book. So our fellow ophthalmologists or our resident, and even some researchers can read the most of it from one basic book, and they can depend their curiosity from any other resources. And at the first time, the book will be published. I think the book will be published by Elsevier or Springer, two of the greatest publishers in the world. However, my friend Dr. Arup Chakrabarti from India told me that it may take 2 years long. It takes the time that we don't have. And some friends suggest, what if Indonesian publisher? It may be interesting because some author need a refreshing beyond Elsevier and Springer. That's so funny. But I think that was no joke, but still funny. They may need some exotic publisher of their work on their CV. That is interesting one. Makes sense. And I decide to choose Indonesian publisher. I and Professor Naveen Rao imagine that the book should be reachable and affordable for every ophthalmologist on every face of this earth. So here we go. We ask some help from Anak Sudarti Foundation, an Indonesian publisher, to publish it for free to all around the world. Yes, for free. Wow, really? Seriously? Yes. A shocking fact that I got an email from a friend. He is a professor. I cherish and I respect him. He told me, Gede, I wanted to share a brief story that I told our resident earlier today. Back in medical school, I spent a little time in a charity eye hospital in southern India, that Sankara Eye Foundation Coimbatore, and was surprised to see residents there from many countries around the world. They had never been outside their country until they got ships of the rural India become ophthalmologists, and they hated it, partly because they had no printed educational resources, no ophthalmic library, and had no learn everything on the job. I remember they kept asking me where they could find books about ophthalmology and cataract surgery. At the time, Amazon.com wasn't a thing, and there was very limited internet speed to watch YouTube videos, etc. A bold statement. When I got home, I sent them a box of surplus basic medical science course from American Academy of Ophthalmology, book which are given free to all residents in the United States. I had inherited this from a friend of a friend who worked in the publishing company in Singapore, where AAO gets all those books printed. So even though much has changed since 2007, I'm certain that our goal of distributing this book at no charge will make a huge difference for a lot of people in resources limited setting all over the world. So congratulations on shepherding this project through near completion. And one more bold statement. One huge laudatory goal of Dr. Pardianto is his intention to make the book available at a very reasonable cost, so all will have access to these resources. The book purports to be a source of otherwise scattered information and hope to provide historic background and solid, reliable information on questions we all have. And eventually, our deepest gratitude goes all of our devoted teachers, inventors, pioneers, and great writers in the field of biometry and IOL power calculation, who have dedicated their lives to serve humanity and eradicate blindness through serving the people, finding formulas, teaching, delivering scientific lecture, as well as writing in books, magazines, and scientific journals around the globe. Some of them have been long gone, but their genuine work and contribution will always shape and light up the world. Thanks to them, the correct IOL powers have been implanted through a huge number of cataract surgeries, which has helped millions of patients around the planet to see better, get back to work, improve their families' well, all of which make the world a beautiful place to live in. Hopefully, our readers will take advantage of this book to help them achieve a better vision for their patients around the world. For indeed, millions of our patients await the opportunity to see the world and work again through the gentle work of our hands. I wish this book will be kind, useful legacy for humanity. And I must sharing a statement before Professor Arshinoff and Professor Naveen Rao give a live statement. Now we are must see the statement from Professor Marie-Jose Tassignon from Belgium. Hafiz, please.
My name is Marie-Jose Tassignon and I'm one of the authors of the book proposed by Professor Gede on the power calculation of the intraocular lenses. And my specific chapter goes, of course, as you could expect, on the back in the lens calculation techniques. Very challenging topic, and I thank absolutely Professor Gede for having asked me to participate as well in this book. And I hope that this book will be a real success, and I wish him all the best.
Thank you. The next statement is from Dr. Magdalena Nenning from Vienna, Austria.
Hello. So first of all, I would like to say thank you very much to all the people involved in this project for making the charity book about IOL power calculations possible. My name is Magdalena Nenning. I'm a resident ophthalmologist from Austria, and together with Professor Oliver Findl, I had the honor to write a book chapter about the history of optical biometry, which I'm very happy about. So thank you very much for this opportunity to be part of this great project, and I hope you enjoy reading the book.
Thank you. The next statement is from Dr. Giacomo Savini from Italy.
Hello, this is Giacomo Savini from Bologna, Italy. It has been a pleasure and an honor for me to be invited to write a chapter for this book. I did my best to describe currently available IOL power formulas with a special focus on the last generation ones, such as, for example, the Hofer QST, which I developed together with Dr. Hofer and Dr. Taroni, the PER-DGS, the EVO 2.0, RBF, K6, LADAS, CASTROP, and so on. IOL power calculation has been my main field of interest in clinical research for the last 20 years, and it is a great pleasure for me to share my little information and knowledge in this field with as many as possible ophthalmologists. So for this reason, I would really like to thank Dr. Pardianto for the great opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you so much. The next statement from Professor Naveen Rao from United States of America.
Dear Dr. Pardianto, it has been my pleasure to be part of this project with you. Thank you for the kind invitation to contribute to your wonderful book about intraocular power calculations. It has been a pleasure for my team, my residents as well, giving them a lot of opportunity to do research into this topic and put their education into writing. So it has been a great benefit to us, as well as hopefully many ophthalmologists in Indonesia and everywhere else in the world. One of the most satisfying parts of this project is that this book will be provided at low cost or perhaps no cost to so many people who could benefit from this information so that it will help their patients see better. Again, we really thank you for the opportunity to be involved in this work, and thank you for all the hard work that it took to put this project together, from the conception of the project to finding a publisher and making sure we met all the appropriate deadlines. You're really very well organized and very capable editor, and I really thank you from me and on behalf of my residents, Dr. Hughes, Dr. Dhawlikar, and Dr. Dai. Thanks again, and best wishes to you on this rollout of your book.
Thank you so much. And then the statement from Professor Steve Arshinoff from Canada.
Hi, this is Steve Arshinoff of Toronto, Canada. I was very fortunate a few years ago to meet Dr. Gede Pardianto of Indonesia. Initially, we met so that I could do some work with some of his residents. And then after a discussion of other issues, he invited me to take part in his book entitled The Intraocular Lens Power Calculation, which he intended to distribute free around the world. Just the fact that he intended to do it free is remarkable for any ophthalmologist. He found the Anak, Sudarti Foundation of Indonesia to sponsor it, and now it is coming to publication and to be distributed very soon, and indeed it will be available to any ophthalmologist who wants it. The book is only a little over 100 pages long, but it has contributions from multiple esteemed authors in the field around the world, and is a really excellent resource to allow anybody to go through all of the data available, which is complex and hard to find, on intraocular lens calculation, make good sense out of it, and proceed to develop a good method for themselves to do IOL calculations accurately. So I congratulate Gede and all the other contributors, and I wish everybody the very best in the success of this book, which I think is excellent and should do extremely well. Thank you very much for asking me to speak.
Thank you so much. Before Professor Arshinoff live speech, please pay attention to our video.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Now we are ready for Professor Steve Arshinoff's speech or short lecture. Professor Steve Arshinoff is a professor from University of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Steve, the time is all yours.
Well, thank you very much, Gede. I have not prepared a speech, so if later you want me to talk about something, I'll think of something to talk about. I want to congratulate you, Gede, on a tremendous achievement in producing this book and distributing it really to everybody who wants in the world for free. It's an amazing accomplishment. Among the things I did to prepare for this, which was not that much, but I did some, is I read the book again last night to make sure that I was happy with what I was looking at and talking about. And the thing that impressed me is how much information you have in this brief book of 100 pages. It really comes from articles that have been coming at us probably every few weeks or every month for about 40 years in ophthalmology. And I think every one of us struggles in our own practices to decide exactly how we are going to achieve accuracy in biometry. And particularly someone like me who does 90% bilateral cataract surgery, you know, when you do bilateral cataract surgery, you don't really want to have an error in biometry. When I see my patients on the first day post-op, it's very reassuring to see that they're all seeing 20/20 or close to it, and they're happy. And if I get someone who's a 20/60 or 20/80 or not quite what I planned, I wonder what went wrong. And then we go and we examine our processes again and try to see if we should change something and how we do our biometry. When you read this book, you'll see that every one of these very esteemed authors went to great detail in describing methods of biometry, enhancing or discussing more the ones they like than the ones they think are antiquated. But no one in the entire book went and said to you, do it like this. They all gave you lots of information and they leave it to the reader to go through the entire book and decide for yourself exactly how you want to proceed with doing biometry. It's one of the still most difficult things that we do in ophthalmology and upon which there is no universal agreement on how to do it best. All I can tell you is I suggest that you read the book carefully, perhaps more than once, decide what equipment you have, how you have to measure different things, and how you're going to proceed, and then monitor your own results. If you monitor your own results, you'll be amazed at how often you go back and you correct what you're doing because you find little things that don't work out quite well when you do that. So I want to congratulate Gede in providing this book to everybody, which I think we will probably have to update in a couple of years, Gede, because there's more and more information coming out all the time. But I think it's terrific, and it is probably the only resource other than the American Academy website where you can find information, as well as the ASCRS, on how to do biometry and how to proceed and do well. But nothing is better than having a book in your hand or on your computer that you can review and decide what gives you good information and how to proceed. So thank you for including me. I congratulate all the authors and Gede for this tremendous project, and also the Anak Sudarti Foundation for supporting it. And thank you for allowing me to take part.
Thank you so much, Steve. Professor Steve Arshinoff from Canada has been my idol from I was a resident of ophthalmology back to 2002. Now it is very honor to be one team with him in this book project and in the several projects of scientific events of ophthalmology. I am beyond grateful and thankful. Thank you so much, Steve, for opportunity to know you and work around you. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much. As I told you before, Gede, those of us who are fortunate enough to have people like you who sort of idolize us and look at us, probably because we're old, mostly we learn from our students. And so I learned a lot from this project, and I expect to learn a lot more from the people at Erlanga as we have an association in the future. It's a great pleasure for me and an honor. Thank you.
All right. Now I would like to ask Professor Naveen Rao, are you able to give a speech, Naveen? Because right now, Professor Naveen Rao is driving from his peaceful home to the office. Professor, do you copy? Maybe Professor Naveen Rao is not able to give a speech because the law in the United States not allow driving and speaking. Now we are approaching the closing ceremony of this book launch. Our distinguished participants, thank you so much for your coming right now. Your participation are so appreciated, highly appreciated, and truly appreciated. Our distinguished participant, our next webinar will be 23rd Maestro. Will be with Professor Wiese from Utrecht University of Netherlands. It will be held on October 31st to 2022. The link will be sent via email. And we try to reach question and answer. Professor Steve, this is a question from Dr. Morteza Mortazepi from Iran. Would you like to answer?
Sure, what's the question?
Okay. Dear Steve, as a leading surgeon in SBCS, how do you predict the future of IOL power calculation? ISBCS, I think.
You know, I think it's not that complicated. I'm actually quite fortunate to live in one of the wealthy countries of the world. And so what we do is we just buy expensive toys to measure things accurately. And we make sure that we measure everything twice before we go to surgery. So I have always, as you saw in the chapter that I wrote, there's a little table on the instruments that you can measure different numbers we need to get. And everything we do, we measure twice and we check it. And we always measure both eyes, even if a patient only comes in to do one eye. And then fortunately for me, I have an assistant now who's a student who plans to go to medical school, who has skills in computer science and writing programs. And he's written us a program to compare really all of the modern equations in the world for every single patient. And so I get now a table at the end of my IOL calculation methods, comparing every equation that we have for each patient. And I can look at them and see if there are any outliers or if there's any reason that I should be concerned about this patient. Usually it's all fine and everything correlates and I pick a lens and it's almost always extremely accurate. On the odd chance that something is off, we then go and repeat all of the tests again before we do the surgery. And by repeating them again, if they are consistent with the first go around, my assumption is that the patient's two eyes are different. If we repeat them again and we get a different result, then we have to look and see why we got a different result and what equations are most accurate. So basically it's hard work. And if you do that and put in the effort and you look at different equations and measure everything twice, you tend to have a very, very low incidence of significant errors. And I think we all have to do that. In the chapter that I wrote, I talked about looking at also at the cost of the devices you have, because in different parts of the world, you know, everybody has a limited budget. And you have to look at these things and choose the devices you're going to use that are not outrageously impossible to buy, and make sure that you still measure things twice and you'll get very good accuracy. That's what we do.
Okay. Thank you so much, Professor Steve Arshinoff. Thank you so much, Professor Naveen Rao. And please send my regard to your family, Professor Steve and Professor Naveen. And especially for Professor Professor Steve Arshinoff, ladies and gentlemen, Professor Steve Arshinoff is also adjunct professor for Erlangga University in Indonesia. We thank Professor Arshinoff and Professor Naveen Rao at this very moment. And the question from Dr. Surjan Kaliasa from India, we will send the ebook to your email. Please be patient. Thank you so much for your question. And once again, thank you so much, Steve. Thank you so much, Naveen. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you very much. It's a great pleasure and an honor.
Thank you. Thank you. And dear participants, once more, the ebook will be sent to your email, hopefully before 2 weeks. And please check the spam folder to ensure you receive the ebook, just in case. Your participation is highly appreciated. See you all. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much, all of our marvelous friends from all around the world. And to all friends from Indonesia, Happy Independence Day, Indonesia. Salam Merdeka. Thank you so much. You all rock. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'm very happy because of you. Thanks to you, this book, this project will be enlighten the world, I hope, hopefully. Thank you so much. Salam Merdeka. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you. so much. Thank you. Thank you so much.